Let us now see how to calculate the magnitude of focal length of different lenses. As in the previous section, we have discussed the lens maker's formula, which is given as 1 by f as mu minus 1, 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2, where r1 and r2 are the radii of curvature of the two surfaces of lens. Here, for different type of lenses, if we just see the magnitude, direct relations we can deduce from lens maker's formula, which are quite helpful in different numerical problems. Like, if we just see for biconvex or biconcave lens, in this situation we know that R1 and R2 are on the opposite side of the lens, so these will have opposite signs when these are used in lens maker's formula. So, in this situation, if R1 is negative, R2 positive, or R1 positive, R2 negative, we can see these two terms will always be added. So, we can directly write by simplifying the focal length of the lens, we can write as R1 R2 by mu minus 1 multiplied by R1 plus R2. Here, this is the magnitude of the focal length, plus or minus, you can substitute depending whether it is a converging lens or a diverging lens. One that will be used for image formation that we'll see later. Here the magnitude of a biconvex or biconcave lens can be directly given in this way. And for equiconvex or equiconcave lens, if we talk, then in case of equiconvex or equiconcave, R1 and R2 are equal, say if this is equals to R, then directly from this relation we'll get the focal length as R by twice of mu minus 1. This is the relation we use. As here in this expression, if we substitute R1 is equals to R2 equals to R, then this will be R by 2 into mu minus 1. Now, if we talk about plano convex or plano concave lens, then in this situation we know that R1, one radius of curvature can be taken as R, another radius of curvature R2 will tend to infinity, and from this expression directly we can write the value of focal length can be given as R by mu minus 1, whether it is plano convex or plano concave. The magnitude can be directly given by this expression. And if we talk about concavo-convex or convexo-concave lens, these are the lenses in which we know that R1 and R2 both are on the same side of lens, so they'll always have same signs. In sign convention, if we use it in lens maker's formula, so both of these terms will be having opposite signs here, whether R1 positive, R2 negative, or R1 negative, R2 positive. So, on simplifying this, the focal length of a concavo-convex or convexo-concave lens can be given as R1, R2 by mu minus 1, and we can take the difference of the two, R1 and R2. So, this is the way how we can directly calculate the focal length of these four different kind of lenses. So, many students might feel what will happen if R1 is equals to R2 in convexo-concave or concavo-convex lens. Then, in that situation, the two surfaces of the lens will be parallel to each other and it will behave like a glass slab rather than a lens, and no effect will be there on a beam of light if it is incident on such a lens where the two radius of curvature are having same values. So, we can consider its focal length to be equal to infinity because it is neither converging nor diverging a light beam.